My name is Melissa Romo, and today we're going to be reviewing MATLAB's if-else statements. If-else statements are used when there are specific conditions that need to be met before the statements will be executed. We're going to go over the general format of an if-else statement. If condition 1 is met, statement 1 and statement 2 will be executed. If condition 1 is not met, MATLAB will move on to the first else if statement. Else if condition 2 and condition 3, statement 3. This means that both condition 2 and condition 3 must be met in order for MATLAB to execute statement 3. If these conditions are still not met, MATLAB will continue to move on and check the conditions. We can create another else if statement. Else if condition 4 or condition 5, statement 4. This means that either condition 4 or condition 5 can be met and statement 4 will be executed. You don't need them to both be met here. You can create as many else ifs as you'd like. When you're done and you have no more conditions that you want to check, you can end it with an else. This means if none of the above conditions are met, then execute statement 5. We end the overall if-else statement with the end. This is the general format of an if-else statement. Now let's work on an example. The example for the if-else statement is going to be creating a script that returns the corresponding letter grade for the integer grade of a quiz that the user inputs. The integer grade must be between 0 and 10, including 0 and 10. If the integer grade is a 10 or a 9, then the letter grade will be an A. If the integer grade is an 8, the letter grade will be a B, 7 a C, 6 a D, and 0 through 5 will be an F. If the quiz grade is less than 0 or greater than 10, we will say that the letter grade is an X, showing that there is an error. Let's begin the code for this. What do we need to do in the beginning? First, we need to ask the user to input a numerical grade. We do this with the built-in MATLAB function input. Input, enter numerical grade. We want to assign this input to a variable that we're going to call quiz. And we end the statement with a semicolon. Once we have that input, we're going to say if the quiz is less than 0 or the quiz is greater than 10, the grade is going to be X. This is our error check. And here we see that we use the OR. If the quiz is between 0 and 10, then we move on. Else if the quiz equals 9 or the quiz equals 10, then we want to assign the grade to the letter A. Here we use the single quotes because these are a string and not a number. Moving on, else if quiz is 8, the grade is B. Else if the quiz is 7, the grade is C. else if the quiz is 6, the grade is D. Now, if none of these conditions are met, the grade must be F. Now we're going to end our statement. And now we want to display our results. We're going to do that using fprintf. We're going to say the integer grade for this quiz is %d. This is a placeholder for an integer, which is what the quiz grade is. 6, 7, 8, those are all integers. And the corresponding letter grade is %s. This is a placeholder for a string, because A, B, C, D, F, those are all strings. The backslash n is for a new line. And then we have the quiz, which is the first variable that we want to input, comma, grade, which is the second variable that we want to input. Now we're finished, and let's run it and see what happens. Come up here and hit the run button. It's ran letter grade, which is the name of the script, and it's asking for me to enter the numerical grade. So let's enter an invalid grade, 11. That's greater than 10. What does it give us? The integer grade for the quiz is 11, and the corresponding letter grade is X, because it's an error. Let's try again. Enter the numerical grade. Let's enter 7. The letter grade is C, which is what it's supposed to be. Perfect. Here is an assignment for you to practice using the if-else statements. Write a script called print sine degree or radian that does the following. If you have any questions on this assignment or on this topic, please come to the next SI session and I will be able to assist you. Thank you for watching.